Hi there. Today I'm going to do another quick and easy Darktable tutorial. And what I'm going to do today is produce a quick atmospheric sort of image that's going to use the color correction module, the tone curve module, the vignette module, and creating a mask to draw attention to certain details of an image. So what I have here is an image that I made a couple weeks ago. It's just my hand holding some dice. The lighting setup was very simple. I took the picture very quickly in my kitchen using the overhead lighting, which functions very much like a large softbox. So it's a nice even lighting. And what I'm going to do to begin with is I'm going to begin by operating on the tone curve module. Now, in a previous video that I made, someone addressed the issue that I don't actually use the exposure module very much on my images. And this is true. The reason for that is that I shoot raw mostly, and while shooting raw produces what might be considered a flat image, the exposure in that image is actually correct. If you underexpose or overexpose, even if you shot raw, while it does give you greater latitude and flexibility in fixing that image, if you have your exposure correct, it's still a correct exposure. So, to my mind, operating on the tones of the image makes more sense than operating on the exposure, which, if it's correct, it's correct. So what we're going to do now is go ahead and activate the tone curve module. I'm going to create a S-curve, which is going to lighten things up a bit and make my blacks a little bit darker. So now you notice that in the more shadowed areas, such as on the fingers here and the dice themselves, things have darkened up quite a bit. Now, for the fingers, that's fine. But in a bit, we're going to go ahead and do something about the dice, because at this point, they're too dark. And as that is the focal point of the image, what I want to do is be sure to draw the viewer's eye to there. So I've tweaked my tone curve to a point that I like it, and of course I can always revisit it later. So I'm going to go ahead and close that module. And what I'm going to do now is I'm actually going to open the levels module. I'm going to activate it, and I'm going to use Darktable's drawn mask function. Now, mask was something I waited for a long time with Darktable, and I'm happy to say that the way it's implemented is really incredibly useful. Now, when using masks, you can either draw by freehand your selection or use the shapes that come preset, such as circles and ellipses. What I'm going to do, though, is add a path. So I'm going to click on the Add Path button, then I'm going to come over to where I'm going to make the path, and I'm going to draw points around the dice. Now, coming from GIMP or Photoshop, the way you add a selection in Darktable took a little bit of getting used to. But once you get over that initial appearance issue, it's very easy to use. So now I have that selection, as indicated by these dotted lines. What I like about the selection tool is that I can increase and decrease it by using the scroll wheel on my mouse. And I'm actually going to decrease the radius, the blur effect for the selection tool a little bit, just right there. And now when I move my sliders in the level dialog box, it's only going to affect the dice. So as we can see, we can lighten that up right there very nicely. just going to add a bit of contrast to that. So I'm okay with that. And what I'm going to do now is go over to the color correction module. The color correction module is very useful. It can be used for adding a global tint to the image. It can be used for split toning. It operates on the highlights and shadows separately. You'll notice that selection tool right now is a white circle, which is for the highlights. But if you move it, you see the dark circle, which affects the shadows. Putting them both together creates a global tint, while setting them in different positions will create more of a split tone. And what I'm going to do is I want to add sort of a cooler tint and give my image a little bit of a cross-processed feel. But I want to make it a little understated. So I'm going to go ahead and lower my saturation to about 80. So it's an understated sort of saturation there. Actually, I'm going to go for about 85. So now I have the tone I like. I like the shadows and the highlights there, but I really want to draw the viewer's eye to the detail in the center, the dice themselves. So I'm going to add a bit of a vignette. Now I'm going to shape this vignette, make it a little more of an ellipse, and I'm also going to scale it down a little bit. I'm going to make some slight changes to the falloff strength and to the saturation, because I don't really want the edges to lose the saturation as they will in their default state. And I'm also going to bring up the brightness just a little bit too, because I don't want a super dark vignette. I want something that subtly leads the eye to the center of the image. Or if it was off-centered more, I'd want it to lead it to wherever my focus was. So now I have that set, but the framing of the image is a little bit off for me, and I'm going to want to do a crop. So I'm going to go to the crop tool. I'm going to activate that. And I'm going to position that to an area that I like. Double click, and it will crop the image for me. So now that I have that, I'm going to go back to my tone curve, and I'm going to actually create another instance. Create another slight S curve, but this time I'm going to make a little more of a curve for the shadows. And bring up those highlights a bit. And I'm going to go ahead and close that module. And now we can go back over here to the history stack and take a look at where we started. This is the original image. And where we've ended up. As we can see, we've made quite a difference. Now, there are two last things that I would do. I suspect that there is some lens distortion going on in this image, so I'm going to come over to the lens correction module, and you see here that it has already identified my camera, the Fuji X10. I'm going to activate that module, and I'm going to select lens, which in this instance is going to be Fuji and standard. And I was right, there was a little bit of distortion going on, so I've corrected that. And the last thing I'm going to do is use a preset I have called Sharpen Plus, which makes a little bit more of a sharpening effect than what has already been established by Darktable when I opened the image. And so at this point, I would just export the image. And that's about it. I know this was a really quick tutorial. If anyone has any questions, feel free to ask me in the comments. And I actually plan to do another tutorial using the same image using raw therapy, and I'm going to link to that in the comments for this video. That's it for now. I'll have another video shortly. Thanks for joining me.